Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RI Design Basics. Today I am going to explain you the Wilkinson power divider, which is a power divider having properties of matched at all the ports, port 1, port 2 and port 3, and it is reciprocal but lossy. So a Wilkinson power divider is matched to all its port, is reciprocal and lossy. That means it is not lossless because there is resistance having value 2Z0 connected between the port 2 and port 3 at lambda by 4 section. So basically the construction of this Wilkinson power divider is there are two lambda by 4 section which is dividing from the input port, and the characteristic impedance of this lambda by 4 section is root 2Z0. All the input ports transmission line will be Z0, including port 1, port 2 and port 3, and a 2Z0 resistor is connected like this. So how this Wilkinson power divider works? When power is input from the port 1, it will divide in two parts and it will reach port 2 and port 3. Now if there is any reflected power due to mismatch at the output port, suppose I have placed a load which is having a different impedance than the characteristic impedance Z0, in that case there will be mismatch at the output port, and due to that there will be reflection. So the power reflected from the mismatch of the output port will coupled into the resistor and it will be dissipated. So we are using this lossy property to dissipate the reflected power so that it will fulfill all the criteria of a three-port network, which we know that all the three conditions, matching, reciprocity and lossless condition, cannot stand together. Rather we have to compromise with one of the property. Here we have compromised with the lossless property and we have made a lossy network, but this loss will happen only for the reflected power from the port 3 or port 2. So for finding S parameter of this three port network, we are following a method which is called as even odd mode analysis. So the method name is even odd mode analysis. What is even odd mode analysis? We will give two different voltages at port 2 and port 3. When we give same voltage with same magnitude and phase, then that particular case is called even mode. In another case, we will give same magnitude but opposite in phase. That mode is called odd mode. So let us say if I am giving input voltage at port 2 as 2V0 and 2V0. That means both voltage is same, where V0 is a constant. 2V0 and 2V0, both voltage is constant and its sign is also positive. So this mode is called even mode. For odd mode, we have to give plus 2 volt 2V0 here and minus 2V0 at port 3. So what will happen? The overall voltage at port 2 will become 4V0 and overall voltage at port 3 will become 0. That means when we are superimposing both the modes together, we are exciting only one port, and then we are seeing how other ports voltages are changing. So same thing can be repeated for port 3, and we can find its characteristic, and this is how we can calculate the S parameter. So now I am going to discuss about this even odd mode analysis. So first of all, we will normalize all the impedances in this transmission line, and we will draw the circuit by dividing the circuit in two parts from this dotted line. So let us divide that and draw the circuit again. So for the top line, it will be a resistor, that is for the this characteristic impedance, because this Z0, if we normalize with Z0, it will become 1. If I normalize root 2 Z0 by Z0, this will become root 2. But as of now, since we have to calculate this value also, I'll just put a Z value for this characteristic impedance, and we'll calculate that Z is root 2 Z0. So this characteristic impedance is it's 1, and 1 divided in two parts parallelly, it will become 2. So another one will be here. So this is also 2. Both are connected in parallel. So I have just written two different resistors, and after that, so this is how it is divided in two parts. In the first one, this is the transmission line of impedance Z and length lambda by 4. Then this transmission line is connected with Z0 characteristic impedance. So I will put Z0 divided by Z0, that is 1. And we'll connect a source here which can be excited. And let's name it as VG2. Similarly, in the other side also, we have the transmission line, then resistor, and we have a source, and the name of this source is VG3, because it's port 3, so VG3, that is voltage of this generator or source. Here we have 2Z0, so it will be divided in two parts. Total normalized impedance is 2, and if we divide it into two parts for symmetricity, this will become 1 and 1. But if we don't know the value, we can say that this value is R by 2. R by 2, later on we will prove that R is equal to 2. And this is the top line of the microstrip line. So I'll put the bottom one, we just ground. Here also we can do like that. This is port 3, port 2, the port 1. Here if we look, it's port 1, which is divided in two parts due to this bifurcation. Now I'll take one of this portion. So if we divide from here, it will have a short circuit or open circuit based on the voltage excitation on these two ports. If VG2 equal to VG3 and equal to 2V0, means if we excite with same voltage, this dotted line will be open circuit, because both the circuits, upper side and lower side circuit, is same, and we are exciting with same voltage, so it will create a open circuit at this line. If VG2 and VG3 having same voltage and having opposite magnitude, then this line will create a short circuit. So I can write if Vg2 equal to minus Vg3 and that is equal to 2V0, in that case there will be a short circuit. In the first case it will be open circuit. So by using this two concept, we are going to draw this circuit for open and short circuit. That means by taking same voltage and negative and positive voltage. So let us take that. Take the even mode analysis first. And in even mode, as I have said, this circuit will be bisected in two parts. And here we will have open circuit. Wherever there is bisection, we will have an open circuit. So let us redraw one of the portion of this where Vg2 and Vg3 both are excited with the same voltage, that is 2V0. So let's draw it. This length is lambda by 4, R by 2, this is also open circuit, this is also open circuit. Here the value is 1 and then we have 2V0 as excitation. Also let us assume that this voltage is V2E. Similarly, for if I take the lower part, this voltage will become V3E, that means for the even mode, voltage at port 2 or port 3. So when I am looking into this port, what I am seeing is this lambda by 4 transformer having a load of 2. So as per the lambda by 4 transformer, and if I say this is input impedance in even mode, then Zin E will be, because these two lines will not have any effect here because of its open circuit. So no current will flow in these two lines. So entire current will be flowing in this line only, main line only. So Zin E will be the impedance of this, let's say Z. Square by the load, because the lambda by 4 transformer, we know that Z lambda by 4 is Z naught square, sorry, Z input impedance is Z naught square by ZL, so that Z naught will be Z in into Z. So using this concept, we can find Z in E equal to Z square by 2, and this Z in E to have matching with this resistance should be equal to 1. If I am looking into this port from here, then it must be equal to the resistance so that there will not be any mismatch at this point. So it is 1 equal to Z square by 2. So we can calculate Z as root 2. So this is how we can calculate the impedance of lambda by 4 transformer, and that is Z equal to root 2. Now we have to calculate the voltage at this point by knowing the voltage at this point. Let's assume that the voltage at port 2 is V2E and voltage at port 1 is V1E. So to calculate this, we need to know the transmission line equation, and that transmission line equation is Vx equal to V plus e to the power minus j beta x plus e to the power plus j beta x gamma into e to the power plus j beta x, where gamma is the reflection coefficient at load. So the V2e will be, this V2e means voltage at this point. We have just now calculated Zne, which is looking into the port 2, is 1, and already this resistance is 1. So effectively this 2V0 will divide in two parts. One is V0 across this, another one V0 across this. So V2e is nothing but V0. And V1e and V2e can be calculated in form of this transmission line equation as, let us assume that this is x equal to 0 and this point is x equal to lambda by 4, minus lambda by 4. This is x equal to 0 and this point is x equal to minus lambda by 4. So V2e equal to V minus lambda by 4, which if we put in the equation, it will become JV plus into 1 minus gamma. Because when we put this lambda by 4 here in beta, beta is 2 pi by lambda, x is lambda by 4. So beta x is, let me show that, beta x is 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 4. So lambda cancelled, is pi by 2. And if it is minus pi by 2, this will become j. So this is how we can get jv plus 1 minus gamma. Similarly, we can calculate v1e, and v1e is v0. If I put v0, this will become v plus into 1 plus gamma. Since we know v2e is v0, we can easily calculate the v plus. So let us calculate v plus as v2e equal to jv plus 1 minus gamma. So v plus will be, and v2e is v0, so this will be v0 by j into 1 minus gamma. So this is v plus. Now apply v1e, which is equal to v0, that is equal to v plus into 1 plus gamma from this equation. So we can put v plus value from here, and it will become v0 by j into 1 minus gamma into 1 plus gamma. That is, if I take j above, this is j v0 gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1, where gamma is reflection coefficient at this point, where 2 will act as a load, and root 2, that is z equal to root 2, we have calculated z equal to root 2, this will act as a line. So load and line. So the reflection coefficient, as we know, ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0, which will be equal to 2 minus root 2 by 2 plus root 2. So by putting this value, we can calculate V1e as JV0 2 minus root 2 by 2 plus root 2 plus 1 divided by 2 minus root 2 by 2 plus root 2 minus 1, which if we calculate, we will get minus j v naught into root 2. Now we will do odd mode analysis, and for that we are going to again take this circuit and redraw it. So the circuit will be here. There will be a short circuit, then a transmission line of lambda by 4 having characteristic impedance already found, which is equal to root 2, and a resistance having value R by 2. R need to be found, which is expected to be 2, and here again we have a short circuit. Let us assume the different voltages here. This voltage is V2O for port 2 voltage in odd mode analysis, V1O port 1 voltage for odd mode analysis, 2, 1. Now since this is a short circuit, there will not be any current flowing in the 2 resistor. This normalized value up to this resistor, there will not be any current flow, so all the current will be flowing through this short circuit. Secondly, because of this short circuit, so effectively there will be a load of 0 at this point for this lambda by 4 transmission line, and to calculate the input impedance due to this transmission line, we can write Zin equal to Z0 square upon ZL. ZL is 0 because of the short circuit load, so this will become infinity. That means there is no current flowing into this direction. There is no current flowing in this direction. Rather, all current is flowing in this direction only. So to calculate that current, let us take the voltage. This is 2V0 for port 2. And find out what will be the voltage at this point. So V2O will be, and also this should be matched. I mean, this is 1. So this should be also 1. Then only there will be matching at this point. That means R by 2 must be equal to 1. We say that R equal to 2, which we are expecting. R should be 2. Apart from that, the voltage V2O will be V0. Because V0 will be dissipated across this resistor, so remaining V0 will be across this resistor. So now we can calculate the input impedance of the combined circuit, and what we will find is, if we have this combined circuit, then to calculate this input impedance, what are the things we need? Here we have Z0 1, the normalized value is 1. Since when we take this combined circuit and find input impedance looking into this, there will not be any current flowing through these two resistors because of same value here. So this is 1, and from 1 it will convert to 2, and finally we can calculate the value as Zin, which is equal to half due to the parallel combination, half of this root 2 square characteristic impedance square divided by the load impedance is 1. So this half is due to the parallel combination of these two lines. Root 2 is the characteristic impedance, square of this divided by 1. That will give the input impedance looking into this port. So overall impedance will be 1. So if input impedance is 1, we can find out the S parameters. So let us calculate the S parameters of overall Wilkinson power divider. So first we will take S11. S11 is due to the port 1, So just quickly draw the circuit. So this will be the circuit port 1. So at port 1, when you calculate S11, we need to know what is input impedance. Input impedance is 1 and characteristic impedance is also 1. So which will make S11 as 0. Because S11 is 1 minus 1 by 1 plus 1, which is 0. So this is due to the input impedance calculation. Then we have S22. S22 and S33, that is port 2 and port 3, is matched for both even and odd mode analysis. We have already taken the condition of matching. So S22 and S33 will be 0. Now to calculate S12, which is also equal to S21, we have to find these voltages at different ports. So in this case, odd mode analysis, since there is no current flowing in this, V1O will be 0 and V2O is V0. And the previous case, we have already found V1E as minus J V0 root 2 and V2 is V0. So we can find S12 and S21 as V1E plus V1O, that is the total voltage at port 1 divided by total voltage at port 2. So V1E is minus J V0 root 2 plus 0 divided by V0 plus V0, which is minus J by root 2 V0. V0 is cancelled, so it's minus J by root 2. S12 and S21 is minus J by root 2. Now S13 and S31 both are symmetric ports as port 2. So 12, 21, 13, 31 both will be same. From the symmetricity we can write it is minus J by root 2. And S23 equal to S32, this is 0 due to the short or open at the bisection. So there is no transmission between 322 or 223 in either of the case, whether it is open circuit or short circuit. There is no transmission from this resistor to another resistor. So that's why S23 and S32 is 0, and we can write this as S parameter of the Wilkinson power divider as 0, 0, 0. That is the diagonal term S11, S22, S33. 1221 is minus J by root 2. 13 is minus J by root 2. Minus J by root 2. Minus J by root 2. S23, 32 is 0 and 0. And from here we can verify whether our S parameter is lossy or it's matched. So it's matched from this diagonal term, we can say matched, this condition fulfilled. It's also reciprocal, but it's not lossless, because when you take the square of this, 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 square, this will become 1. But in the second and third, it's not becoming, square of the column is not becoming 1. So this is lossy. The network is lossy. So the Wilkinson power divider, from the S matrix, it is very clear that it will divide power in two parts, and both parts will be equal part. Here we have designed equal split. Equal split Wilkinson power divider, because power is dividing in equal parts. S12 and S13 both are getting same, and we can also calculate how much power it is dividing, and based on that we can name it. So if it is minus J by root 2, take this square, square will be half, 10 log of half, so it is minus 3 dB. So we can say this is a 3 dB equal split power divider. We can also design an equal power divider by taking different value of resistance and different value of quarter wave transformer characteristic impedance, and we can find the unequal split at the output ports. Thank you.